Hey guys, it's John from Enduring Charm. Today I want to do a little project that I've been putting off for quite a while now because it's kind of a pain, and that is to change the knives in my jointer. This is an old jointer that I've had for many, many years. It's a 6-inch model. It has three knives, and I've put a lot of antique wood through it recently, and the knives have just become so nicked that it's not really doing its job anymore. I'm going to show you a close-up of the knives. To get this guard off, it's just spring-loaded, and you just lift it right out. Just want to show you a close-up of the blade here so when we're talking about this stuff, you can understand. First of all, here's the nicks that I'm talking about. There's one here, there's a whole bunch here, and there's three blades in this rotation, and all the blades have nicks in one area or another. So sometimes you can actually shift this knife. If one of them has a single nick in it, you can shift the knife this way or that way and get some more life out of it. But in my case, there's no more life to be had. So you can sharpen these blades, but for me, the cost is pretty minimal to buy new ones. So I'm going to take these out, install the new ones, and then I have these as backup if I ever needed them. Now, the way these particular knives are mounted, there's in here, I don't know if you can see that, there's little nuts. There's four of them. Or screws. They're called jack screws. And I'm going to insert a wrench in here. When I tighten the jack screw, that actually loosens the blade. And that's how we'll get them out. Now, I want to explain one other thing as we're going along here. There's three knives or blades in this jointer. So as they come around, they're going to hit the top, which I'm going to call top dead center, which is the point at the highest reach of this knife. And we want all the knives to be in the same place when they reach, or when the rotation reaches top dead center. So there are a few ways of doing that. There are jigs you can buy that are magnetic, which hook onto this area here, the outfeed table, and then help you mount this blade in the same spot every time. I'm not going to use that, but I put this ruler across here to indicate that I have the outfeed table and the infeed table at the same plane or the same level. And I can, if I remove this, I can mark top dead center back here on the fence. And that way, when this comes around, when I move it by hand, I'll know exactly where the top is. Okay, you can see here that I've put a piece of blue tape at what I think is top dead center. So when this knife comes around, that's the area, that's the point at which I think it's at its highest point. I've got the camera kind of right in the way, but I'm going to see if I can do this. They're in there pretty good. Yeah, they're pretty tight. All right, once I'm actually tightening the screw, but that's going to loosen the knife, as I said. And once I get these all out, loose enough, we'll be able to take the whole thing out. All right, and there is the mechanism. And in my case, there are, I'd even forgotten this to be honest with you, there are springs that help mount this. And honestly, I'd forgotten all about that. It's been so long since I changed these, I guess. But here is the knife. All right, I'm going to try to give you a close-up of the system here so you can see it. So the rotating head, in my case, there are two springs, one here and one back here, which will push up against the blade and make it easier to reinstall. Now, you may not have those springs. Not everybody does. Then the blade, this is a new blade here, and you can see the angle or the slope here, how it's installed. And then this is the mechanism, and these are the jack screws here that push against the blade to keep it where it's supposed to be. All right, I've mounted the blade assembly in the rotating head, and I have it right at top dead center. Now, there's multiple ways of doing this. If I had that magnetic jig, which they sell, I think it's called a magnet jig or something like that, it's basically two arms that mount to the outfeed table and are magnetized, and they go over this area here and hold the blade in place. And you can buy that jig. I just never have. I just didn't really see a need for it. You can also take a straight edge made of wood. I'm going to put one here and one here, so on two sides of the blade, and then just push down, and that will because I have the in-feed table and the out-feed table on the same plane, if I push down with these straight edges, that should give me a pretty straight place to start with the blade. And I'm going to take my wrench and just tighten down loosely using these jack screws. All right, I want to show you another close-up here of what I've done. The knife now is installed and these jack screws are tight but not super tight, enough to hold the knife in place. This is just that straight edge that I had before, and I marked the very edge of the outfeed table, and I've marked the very edge of top dead center of this knife. I'm still on the first knife, remember. So now I'm going to set the other two knives to these same two markings, and that should get me pretty close. However, unquestionably, I'm going to have to do a little bit of fussing here. So, you know, as I get all three knives installed, I'm going to go back and just double check to make sure every edge lines up exactly as the others do. One other thing I want to mention, the edge of the blade, in this case, is here and here. You can shift that blade a little bit this way or that way, depending on how you mount it. And again, you want to give yourself a little bit of flexibility so in the future, if you get a little nick on the knife, you can shift the knife a little bit one way, and that way the nick won't be on all three knives. I have my second knife mounted now the same way, and I have it mounted. Here's my marks, remember from last time, on the board. And when I swing this around, at top dead center, it just touches that mark. Now, if this knife is mounted too high, which I did at first, then it picks up the wood and moves it, okay? So if you're just picking up the wood and moving it, it's slightly high. But if I am able to swing this by and it doesn't pick up the wood, but there's no, you know, gap between the wood and the knife, then I know I'm in the same spot. This is kind of hard to show on camera, but if you have to look real closely. And again, I can move this wood back and forth so I can come over on this side and do the check here, do the check in the middle, do the check on all the sides so I know this is right. By the way, if you don't have a spring mounted system, or if you've lost your springs or you just want to be a little safer, you can just use a magnet like this to hold the knife in place or move it up and down. Okay, I've got all three blades installed, not completely tightened down, but installed. And you can see on camera there, there's my mark on the edge of the outfeed table. There's my mark where I think top dead center is. And as the blade goes by, I want to see no gap at all between the blade and the wood. And if the wood gets picked up and moved, I know the blade is too high. So as long as I have no gap and the wood doesn't move, then I know I'm right there where I need to be. And I go to the next blade, same thing. I don't want to see any gap there. Here's the third blade, no gap, and the wood doesn't move. So I know I'm set at the same height on all these knives. All right, here's an example where the blade is too high at one point. I'm going to try this just by hand. Watch the piece of wood. It just catches the wood and moves it. See what happens there? So I know that's actually too high. All right, once I'm satisfied that everything is at the same height, all the knives are the same height, I'm going to crank down on these. Remember, loosening is actually tightening. And I'm going to do it evenly across the whole knife. I'm going to do all three, and I'm going to crank down quite a bit, actually. So I don't want these things coming loose on me, that's for damn sure. But after you've tightened them all that you're going to tighten them, make sure you check this measurement again, because sometimes the act of tightening or loosening these can change the height of the knife. Of course, as we're putting this safety cover back on, we want to make sure there's plenty of spring tension. So I'll create some spring tension here and then drop the plate back in. Right, well, the proof is in the pudding, and this is just a beautiful smooth finish now. So what a difference from the old knives. So it looks like I'm in good shape. However, I will unplug the machine and just double check after running a few pieces of wood through here, double check my height to make sure I'm in good shape. But it looks pretty good right now. And actually the whole process, if I wasn't filming it, would have taken me about maybe 25 minutes, 30 minutes tops. So it's really not all that bad, but you don't want to rush this. You just want to take your time and make sure you get the height correct.